So here it is. This is the DIY home cold plunge using the 150 gallon Rubbermaid tank, some lumber, and a Amazon chiller. And now that I've been using it for a while, I'm gonna give a little bit of a rundown on what I think about it and what I would change. Well, I might as well get in. Maybe I can talk a little bit while I'm in here. So, this particular cold plunge, I keep it right around 38 degrees. Right now it's in the upper 80s, low 90s, where I live here in southern Indiana. And it hasn't been struggling at all. The first day I fired it up, the water started around 76 degrees. And once I got it going, it took about 2.5 hours to get down to around 38 degrees. So I was kind of impressed. And since then, man, the thing's been just doing really, really well. I don't have a problem with leaks because I followed the plans really well. It is a 150 gallon Rubbermaid tub. The lumber that is composing the bottom of it is treated lumber, since it's going to have the most moisture. I've got a moisture barrier wrapped around it, which I will detail. It's got a rubber mat for the top of it, and then wooden decking for the sides over the top of the insulation. And the tub itself has been insulated with about 12 cans of spray foam. I think that helps a lot as far as keeping the temperature down. At one point I shut off the pump and the chiller just to see how well it would maintain, and I think it lost, or it increased about 0.5 degree of temperature for every hour I had it unplugged. So that wasn't bad at all either. And the assembly was pretty easy, assuming you have the tools you need. You need a pocket hole jig, a drill, miter saws handy, circular saws a must. And you just follow the plans and it goes together really, really well. Anything I would change? Honestly, I might move the input and outputs for the water flow on it to slightly different places, but that's not really all that big a deal. I would probably increase the height of the top of the deck on this thing by about 2 inches, and maybe increase the width by another couple of inches to accommodate the chiller. The chiller was a tight fit. The chiller is an Amazon sold Vivor 1.5 horsepower water chiller made for aquariums, up to a 500 gallon aquarium. The specs say it's to keep water between like 65 and 85 degrees. However, you can set it down to 36 degrees and it has no problem getting down there as long as you keep the water moving through. It does need airflow. On my enclosure, there are vents on either side on the access doors to allow it to pull water in from behind it. And then, you know, it has to have airflow in the front so it can blow the exhaust out. You don't want to put this thing in a completely enclosed cabinet. Otherwise, it's just going to overheat. It's not going to work. You also want to keep it out of the weather. It says it's not rated to be exposed to the elements. But, you know, I've got it covered pretty well. And when the winter comes along, I'll probably cover it up anyway, and I'll let the actual weather keep the water cold for me. I'm coming up on my 3 minutes right now, so I'm going to kind of sit here for a second. Then I'm going to get out, and we'll continue talking a little bit more about it. Hey, there's 3 minutes. For those of you that don't do cold plunges, I highly recommend them. They are wonderful for aches and pains and general mental toughness. Also, put your drink in there whenever you're plunging, and it makes it a little easier. Okay, plunge is done. I'm just gonna talk while I'm warming back up. But the exterior construction of this thing was actually pretty easy. Once again, this is all framed by 2x4s under here, according to the plans that I bought online. The exterior decking is just paneling. It's already primed. I'm probably gonna paint it at some point to make it a little bit more weatherproof. I'm using PVC 90 degree trim right here that ignore my miter joints. My saw kind of sucks, so they're not the best. And let's see, over here, these are the 14 inch vents I put on either side. These are access doors here. I've got another one over here that is open, so I could get in there and let you guys see the internals. And you can see how tight it is. I would very much like to have had a little bit more room in there to help just get access to maybe put an ozone generator in there later. But other than that, man, the thing, pretty darn good. It's quiet, as you can tell. I mean, it's running, the pump and the chiller are running right now, and well, you can hear the birds around me. It's not drowning anything out, and the thing works really well. Now, the rubber matting I put on the top, it holds on to dust and dirt a little bit. I need to just wash it off because I keep picking up stuff and getting in my plunge. But another thing I hadn't anticipated. Now, I did lay some 3M adhesive down underneath this and then cut it all to fit. I used silicone caulking around the edges to really get it on there and try to seal any gaps so water couldn't get in. But as you can see now, the sun's just come out. It warms this up. When everything's warm, this thing fits great. But in the evenings, when it cools down, that rubber mat contracts and it pulls. So I'm gonna have to put more silicone caulking in here to take care of that gap and allow it to flex a little bit so I don't end up getting water down there onto the untreated plywood. For my lid, I took the hole or the wood that I cut when I cut the hole in the top of this plywood deck. I held onto it and I just used some insulated pipe wrap. I imagine you could also use pool noodles, and stuck that around the perimeter of it, and it fits perfectly right on the top lip of my plunge to keep stuff out of it and a little bit of just moderate insulation. I'm using an Intex pool pump right down here, and you can see it sweats a little bit, but it's because it's got almost freezing water going through it, and you may be able to see in there, possibly, the insulation on the pool, on the tub itself. It's just great stuff, spray foam. Overall, I did this thing in like 5 days. The wife told me I could build it and for my Father's Day gift, and so I went ahead and did it. It was 5 working days. I had to take a one-day break in there to go to work and got it all slapped together. The chiller itself was on sale on Amazon, and then I used a discount code or a coupon as well, got it for about $377. The Intex pump I already had, but I think that particular one ran around $80. The spa hose, the PVC 1-inch tubing that I use to plumb everything, runs about $475 a foot at my local Home Depot. I can't remember what the vents ran, but you know, depending on what chiller you're using, you may or may not use those. You know, the hinges were a couple bucks a piece. This decking that I used for the exterior, it ran, I'm wanting to say, around $39 for a 4x8 sheet. I used a grand total of 3 sheets. I had some plywood laying around for the top, so I didn't have an expense on that. These tubs run anywhere from like $175 to $200 for the 150 gallon ones. So, you know, that's not terrible. If you look down in there, they come with a drain already. I use silicone caulking around it just to make sure it didn't leak around there. And then over on this side is the hole I had to drill, and I sealed it with silicone as well. That's just a 3/4 inch bulkhead fitting. You can use 1 inch or 3/4 inch. I use 3/4 simply because it's the only one I could find at my local store. They were out of everything else. I guess other people are using them. And honestly, this is a fun project. I have friends that that are asking if they could use it sometime, and it really is. It's an excellent project to have in the heat of the summer. It is a great thing to be able to go do, and I highly recommend it. So if you've been thinking about building a cold plunge, I got the plans for this from the DIYColdPlunge.com. That guy doesn't know me. I don't know him. I just saw his videos, looked at his plans, and they were really well laid out. Even an idiot like me could do it, and it only took me about 5 days once I had all the parts. So I highly recommend doing it. If anyone has any ideas or suggestions for improving them, drop me a message in the comments and maybe I'll give it a shot. Or if you have any questions, throw something in there. Glad to answer anything. That's all I got for now. Take it easy. I almost forgot to mention lumber. As you know, it does take a significant amount of both treated and untreated pine. The lumber, I think, ran me around $130, and you know, prices vary depending on where you are and what time of year it is. So there is that. Then maybe about a $30 container of screws, and $10 here and there for construction adhesive or silicone, depending on how you're, you know, finishing your joints out, stuff like that. The spray foam varies. Usually it's anywhere from $6 to $8 a can if you decide to go that route.
the house wrap, which is the foil stuff you saw inside it. That you can buy that on Amazon by just a huge roll, or you can just use plastic vapor barrier that you can get for next to nothing. Sometimes you get it for free if you're getting it off of something that's already been, you know, thrown away. And I think that's about it. All said and done, I've got way less than $1,500 in this thing. I would say it's probably closer to $12. And yeah, it really is. It's an excellent thing to have, especially when you consider the health benefits to it and building it yourself. You know, something like this, if you had to buy one outright, you're looking at $5,000 to $7,000, and then for the really nice ones, it really starts getting up there. But a lot of people, we don't need something super fancy. We just need something that can get cold and stay cold and is easy to maintain, and that's what you get with this. So I highly recommend it. Melt the ice behind my stone cold eyes. I turn to ashes, but only just sometimes. Inhale your smoke, but you still act surprised. It's not my fault when we end up capsized. You call me crazy now, but you don't understand. I'm calling out to you, can you hear a thing? 'Cause you lit the match.